Hello, friends. I'm Tom Downey. Follow me on Twitter at WhatGoingDowney for more Cowboys coverage. We're going to dive in now to my Cowboys pre-draft big board, starting off with some players who missed my big board. One note here, though, before we get too far in. This is not what I would do. This is what I think the Cowboys big board looks like, and we'll see how accurate it ends up being. We're going to go through 20 guys, no quarterbacks and RBs because, well, that's just not going to happen. Here are some five guys that missed it, guys that could be options they trade down, notable players, but I don't think are in it. I'll mention Courtland Sutton. I know some of you guys like him. Cowboys, I don't think I have a round one grade. I think they have a round two grade on him, so he just misses the cut. We'll start with their top guys here, the guys that, well, they're not going to be available at number 19 overall. Number one, Quentin Nelson. Zach Martin, Quentin Nelson. Maybe instantly your two best guards in the NFL in terms of combo, but he's not going to be there, so we'll go through these guys a little bit faster here. Bradley Chubb, would love to get him. He's not going to get outside the top six picks. Roquan Smith, maybe is a trade-up target, but I don't want to give up that much getting to that top 10, top 8, top 9 range for him. Not going to happen. Tremaine Edmonds, not as good as Roquan, but a freak athlete as well. Could even go above Roquan. I don't think he's going to be as talented as Roquan is right now. But again, a top 5 guy for the Cowboys because he fits that athletic mold so well. Number 5 is Derwin James. I think he goes too high for the Cowboys there. Again, I don't see him sliding anywhere outside of the top, let's say 15 or so picks. So don't get your hopes up for Derwin. To recap those first 5 guys, folks, the guys that aren't going to happen, but maybe if you want to go trade up, which I don't think Dallas is going to do. Nelson, Chubb, Smith, Edmonds, and Derwin James. One quick reaction poll here. Which one would you guys want to trade up for? Is it Roquan, Edmonds, Derwin, or are you like me and no one? I like all those players. They're all top 10 guys this year, but I don't want to give up the assets when you have so many needs. And those three guys also kind of fit into this next guy here, Minka Fitzpatrick. I think he's going to go too early. It would be a great fit for the Cowboys, but he's just not going to last. Number 7 is one of my boys, the guy I would love for him to be there, but I don't foresee Vita Vea falling to number 19 for the Cowboys. I think they would take him if he was there because he is a true 3-down defensive tackle, has some of those 3 technique qualities, but I just don't see Vita Vea being available. Number 8 is Denzel Ward. I think he's going to go maybe even before Vita Vea, but he's a little bit lower on the Cowboys because positional value matters for the Cowboys. Cornerback isn't really a need with Byron Jones, Chidobe Awuzie, Jordan Lewis. If he was there, I think they would try to go ahead and take him there. So I just don't foresee Ward being available anyway. Now we get to the guys that, you know, these are some more likely candidates. Number 9, Leighton Vander Esch. I know you two people in particular, I know you guys don't like Leighton Vander Esch, and I understand why. 1-year wonder, cannot take on blockers very well, but he is super productive and tested almost off the charts at the combine. He is the type of linebacker the Cowboys really like. If he's on the board, I think the Cowboys will take him, but there's a good chance he doesn't even last the number 19 overall, so maybe you kind of, at least from some perspectives, avoid that bullet. Number 10 is Calvin Ridley. Yes, he's not the high-end athlete you want. Yes, he's older than you want as well, but he is a very reliable route runner, a great one at that, going to make an instant impact, a very Dak-friendly player. He, Vander Esch, and number 11, DJ Moore, are all prime candidates here for the Cowboys in the first round. I like Moore a lot the more and more I watch him. Profile is very similar to Sammy Watkins from an athletic standpoint. Had a great combine. Needs some work going deeper downfield. Not quite the deep threat that Sammy Watkins is, at least as he is right now. But I think he's a strong option at number 19 if a receiver is already gone. Or maybe even over Calvin Ridley. Again, 9 through 12 or so, not much separation. At number 12 is Rashawn Evans. I like Evans a lot. I would much rather have him than Leighton Vander Esch, but I don't think the Cowboys feel the same way. They love athletes at linebacker. Evans doesn't quite fit the mold. He's a very good player. He is a better football player than Leighton Vander Esch is, but the athletic upside isn't quite the same. That's why he's a little bit lower, because this is what I think the Cowboys would do. But I want to know from you guys, which player would you rather have the Cowboys draft? Is it Vander Esch, Evans, DJ Moore, or Calvin Ridley? Use those reaction buttons and let me vote. I think those are the 4 most likely players the Cowboys could take in round 1 this year. At number 13 is Harold Landry, and edge isn't the biggest need per se, but if he's there, the Cowboys would definitely consider it. They always are looking for edge rushers. Landry has a great athletic profile. A bit of a down year in 2017, but in 2016 he was incredible. That's the player the Cowboys would be trying to get. Similar deal at number 14, Mike McGlinchey. Not sure he's going to be there. If he is, it would be a discussion. He can play right tackle, left tackle. I think he's best at the right tackle spot, though. That's where the Cowboys play him as well. At number 15 is James Daniels. He gets not over all the other interior linemen because he's the one the Cowboys brought in, and we know that that is a big deal for them. A very, very good athlete. Can play guard or center, and of course would be a guard for the Cowboys. Some size and strength concerns, but I think he's going to be just big enough. Isaiah Wynn is next up. I think a better fit for the Cowboys than, say, Will Hernandez. I think they want a more athletic guard that can pull and move and get to the second level, and that fits Wynn the best. Play left tackle. George will move inside to guard. He's going to be a reliable starter, as will Will Hernandez, a second-team All-American, a mauler, got that bowling ball build. Kind of reminds me of Brandon Brooks as well. Not the best height, not the best athlete, but he's good enough on that end. He is a driver and a mauler. Some issues, though, in pass protection, but he's a guard. You can get by with that. Another reaction poll, folks. Which offensive lineman would you prefer? McGlinchey, Daniels, Wynn, Hernandez? If you want someone like Colton Miller or Connor Williams, let me know in the comments section. Now we'll go back to defense here. Deron Payne checks in at number 18 overall. He's not quite the athlete Vita Vea is. He's a very good one as well, though. But I think he's a notch below Vea on the Cowboys' big board. If Dallas trades down, maybe Payne's an option, but I'd be surprised if he was the pick at number 19, because I think there are better players that maybe, at least from the Cowboys' perspective, bigger needs. Speaking of defensive line, Taven Bryan, he got the nod over Maurice Hurst because the Cowboys brought him in for a visit. He is very disruptive, didn't have the production that Hurst did, but he's a better athlete than Mo Hurst is. He's still raw, not the best power, but Rod Marinelli, I have no doubts, would make him into a great defensive lineman, but my mindset is, I don't want to spend a top 20 pick on a three technique when the Cowboys have David Irving. They have Malik Collins. I think they'll look elsewhere. But if he falls to, like, let's just say round two, I could see the Cowboys doing it. And then one final guy, Marcus Davenport, the edge rusher. I don't think he's as good as Harold Landry. Some do. I don't quite see it. I think he got by just because he was bigger, stronger, faster than the players UTSA went up against. I wouldn't want him in round one. I'd actually be kind of upset if he was the pick. Might not even be there anyway. So I think he's lower on the Cowboys board, but he is the last guy here on my Cowboys projected big board. And then I wonder from you guys as well. Who do you want the Cowboys to take in round one? We'll recap all these guys here as well. Just kind of quickly go from first to worst here. Quentin Nelson leads the way there as well. And then we've got other players like Vita Vea. So we'll take a look here at these in order from number one to number 20. Quentin Nelson leads the way. Bradley Chubb, Roquan Smith, Tremaine Edmonds, and Derwin James. The unlikely guys, but you'd love to get them. Same with Minkah and Vita Vea, Denzel Ward. I don't think they'll be there, but if they were on the board, they'd be the pick. Then some more likely options. Leighton Vander Esch, Calvin Ridley, DJ Moore, Rashawn Evans, Harold Landry, Michael Glinchey, and James Daniels are strong options. Daniels might be like the worst case scenario, I think, for the Cowboys if they miss on the linebackers and wideouts and or if they try to trade down in round one. Then some trench play. Isaiah Wynn, Will Hernandez, Deron Payne, Taven Bryan, and Marcus Davenport as well. Folks, I'm Tom Downey. Follow me on Twitter at WhatGoingDowney. If you missed anything, don't worry. We'll play it again here in just a moment. Until then, we'll see you next time.